Hi everyone. Yesterday we discussed about string programs and also event handling. To continue with the same concept, today we shall see some of the components like radio button and checkbox. How do we use these components in our swing application? So to do that, first we shall have this kind of a form wherein we will take these details from the user, let's say name and a text box, and then we shall ask for the other details like address or contact number. So you can have as many details as per your wish. Here I will just take these things. So this is going to be one radio button. And then we shall have some checkboxes provided to choose the hobbies, maybe singing, dancing, drawing, coding, etc. And then we shall provide a button, submit. Okay, so we will create a form which will look like this, and when the user fills in this form and he submits, we should get something like this. See this name, whatever is the name. Suppose the user has written the name as Neha, for example Neha. Then, and if the user has selected this, okay, so based on this, we should provide a greeting message along with the salutation. For example, it should display Miss Neha, good morning, something like this. Or good morning, Miss Neha. It should display that. Or let's say if it is male, let's say Rahul, for example, and if this radio button is selected, then it should display Mr. Rahul. That means the greeting message along with the salutation Mr. or Miss should be provided. And these hobbies, he must be able to select multiple, he or she must be able to select multiple hobbies over here. So we should provide this kind of a form, and upon submitting, this kind of message should be displayed. So this is what we are going to implement. So to do that, we shall have a class. So let me create a class. Let's take the class name as form demo, and we need the main method as well. So I have chosen this. Fine. And then let's format this properly. So this is our main method, and we shall come back to this main method little later. First we shall create this form using all the swing components that are required. So I will just create a class, let's say form demo 1. So yesterday we discussed that whenever we want to implement any swing application, we need to extend JFrame class. So that JFrame class is present in the package, swing package. So we need to import that, right? So our class has to be the subclass of JFrame. So we have to use the keyword extends and then write JFrame. And immediately when I write this, it is showing an error over here because we need to import the package in which this class is present, right? So if you just click on this, it will show the suggestion. So I'm importing this. Now, so what all are required here? We need all these components. See, this name is a text. So we need a label over here to display this name text. And then we need two text boxes. Two labels, in fact. One is for name and another one is for contact number. That means in all I need two labels and two text boxes and two radio buttons and four check boxes and a button. And look at this, here to display the result or greeting message on the screen, we need another label. That means I need 1, 2, 3 labels, right? So first, let's create those labels. So we need labels. The component or the class used for this is JLabels. Let's take it as L1, L2, L3, right? So we need 3 labels. And then we require 2 text boxes. So let's use the class JTextField. So yesterday we have seen in our previous lecture, I have told you how to use these text fields. So I need 2 text fields, T1 and T2. And then, see, we are done with these 3 labels and these 2 text fields. We require 2 radio buttons. So we have a class JRadioButton. Let me take it as R1 and R2. And then we need 4 check boxes to display these hobbies. So we have a class JCheckbox. So let's consider them as C1, C2, C3, C4. And after that, now we are left with this button, okay? That is submit button. So we need a button, that is J button. J button, let me call it as B1. Okay, so now we will write a constructor for this, wherein we are going to create the instances of these classes. See, these are all just references. Unless I write JLabel L1 equals to new JLabel 1, it is not going to create the instance. So whatever we have done so far are only the references to those classes. So now actually when this object of this form demo 1 is created in the main method, it should create all these objects. So I am writing that in the constructor. So you know that the constructor is a special method which will be automatically called whenever an object of this class is created, right? So how to do that? Let's take it as L1 equals to new JLabel. Right, so what is the label that we want here? So first label is, it should display name, correct? And then we require another label that displays contact number. And this label is L2. So here you can see that we are getting so many red marks over here. So what does it mean? We need to import something. right? So what do we need to import? So if you click on this, you will get to see that we have to import JLabel, we need to import JText field, okay? And we need to import all these components. So if I scroll this up and see, you can see that here it is showing import javax.swing.jframe, JLabel, JText field, JRadio button, J checkbox, all that we need to import. So to avoid so many number of lines of code, we can just write one simple statement wherein we can just mention that we are importing all the classes. So let's write it as star and we can avoid so many statements. We are reducing the number of lines of code from this, right? So now you can see that we are not getting any red marks. That means there are no errors. And similarly, we have to do it for L3 as well. L3 equals to new JLabel. And here I'm not providing anything. This I'm leaving it blank, whereas here I have written it as name and contact number. Why did I leave this blank? The reason is on these two labels, we wanted these text to be displayed. Whereas this we are going to display it at the end depending on what is the name that is provided by the user and also whether he has chosen this or he or she has chosen this or this. Based on that, we are going to display this. We are going to set the text for the label later. So right now I have just created the object without any text on it. Similarly, we have to create the objects for all those text fields and the buttons as well. So let's write it as T1 equals to new J text field. Right? And here we need to give the size. If you don't give the size of the text field, when you execute the code, you will just get one line there. Actually, we need a box having some width, right? Wherein the user should be able to enter the details. So you can accordingly give the size. I'm just giving it as 10. Same thing have to be repeated for the second text field also. So this has to be T2. Okay. And now after that we need to create objects of radio buttons and checkboxes also, right? So for radio buttons we have the references created R1. R1 equals to new J radio button, and do it for, okay, there's a spelling mistake, okay. We have to do this for the second radio button, that is R2. And also we have to create the objects of all the checkboxes, that is C1, C2, C3 and C4. So C1 equals to new J checkbox, right? So I'll just copy this and I will paste it over here because we need to do this for all the four checkbox objects. So let me just change the names. So this has to be C4, C3 and C2. Right? So we have done the buttons as well as radio buttons as well as the checkbox. And what is remaining now is the button. So for button, I have taken the reference as B1. B1 equals to new J button, And here we can just provide the name that has to be displayed on the button. So I want it to be displayed as submit. So let me write this as submit. So far we have just created all the objects, right? And yesterday we saw that whenever we have a Swing application, we first have to set the visibility to true. Otherwise, by default, it is false. So you will not be able to see anything when you run this. So that's very important, and you need to set the dimensions, the size of the window, so that we can do it using set visible and set size. Right, so I am setting the layout, that is flow layout. Yesterday we discussed about the layout. By default it is card layout, and we have seen the drawback of using the card layout. So we are shifted to the flow layout. If you want, you can even use the grid layout so that you can arrange everything properly. And then set visible should be true. And I have taken the size as 400 by 400. It is your wish, whatever size you wish to have, you can provide the number accordingly. Here we need to import the AWT package. So you can see that we have imported the flow layout over here. And now let's execute this and see what we are getting. We are not getting anything because we have to add those components. We need to add all those components to the frame, right? Otherwise, we are just getting one a bar on the top left, right? So first we need to add these to the frame. Right? So how to add that? We have the add method. So what all we need to add? All those. So first we need the label. So add L1 and then add T1, that is the text field, and then add the second label which is there in L2 and add T2, that is second text field. And then we have the radio buttons. We need to add the radio buttons. Add R1 and add R2. Add. After that we need to add the checkboxes, so which are there in C1, C2, C3, C4. So we need to repeat this for all those. C1, C2. Right, and after that we need to add the button, that is add B1, and then we need the last label to be added, which is there in L3. Okay, now we are done with all the components. We have added all the components, right? So let's run this code and check whether we get the expected output here. Yes, you can see that we have got all of these. You can observe that we have got the labels and the text fields, everything properly displayed. Only problem is we are getting the radio buttons and checkboxes without any labels on that. Why are we getting this? Because when we created the object, we did not provide any text for those. So if you remember here, so let's go back to the code. Here you can see that these are empty. We need to provide these labels. We need to provide these labels, right? So that's the reason we are getting it empty. So let's provide these details. And once we provide all these, we will be able to see. So here we have to provide the hobbies. So first one is this, and we have to provide four hobbies because we have created four checkboxes. And then here is the third one that I have taken it as drawing. And then here is coding. Right, so now let's run this code. Yes, now we are able to see all this. Okay, so now you can see that we have name, contact number, and those male and female radio buttons and all those hobbies. Right, so now you can just give the name and the contact number, and you have to choose whatever. See, why it is allowing me to choose both? See, when we have radio button, it should allow me to choose any one, right? So here, when we are writing the code, we have to take care of one thing. So let's go back to the code and see. Here, before adding these radio buttons, I will create one button group. So let's take the button group BG equals to new button group and create a group of these two radio buttons, so that it will allow me to use any one button. So bg.add that is R1, R2, bg.add. That means I am adding these two radio buttons to the group, one group. And here okay, so I have misspelled this, so this has to be group. Okay, so now run the code and see whether it works properly. Fine, we have got all this. So after entering the name, let's say Neha, give some contact number and then choose this. And now if I'm trying to choose this, see, in the earlier case, both were getting selected. Now it is letting me to select anyone. So that's how you can make a group of these buttons wherein you want any one to be chosen from this. Otherwise, it will allow me to choose both, which is not relevant here. Right? And also, you can just select these checkboxes. Right? And when I submit this, it should do something. So that's what we have discussed, right? When we submit this, it should greet that person with a proper salutation, right? So that part we have to do. So that is event handling. When you click on the button, what action should be performed? So that part we need to implement. So where is our button is B1, right? So B1 dot add action listener. So we have discussed about this already in the previous lecture. So, and we are passing this object, and since we are using the add action listener method, which is present in the action listener interface, our class must implement the action listener interface. So here we need to add implements action listener, and for this we need to import a package, right? So we have done this, and once we implement this interface, we should make sure that we are going to override the abstract methods which are declared in the action listener interface, right? So for that we are overriding this. Let me take it as action event A. You can give any name for that. So what action should be performed here? When button B1 is clicked, it should take the name from the text box T1, right? So T1 dot get text, right? So what should be done with this? We need to add the salutation, right? That is Mr. or Miss, based on what is selected here. So how to do that? So to do that, first we need to check whether it is selected. So if R1, see R1 is our radio button 1. If R1 dot is selected, so is selected is a method which returns a boolean value, either true or false. Okay, so if it is selected, that means we need to give the salutation as Mr., right? So let me take a variable of type string, string name equals to. So what we should do here, we want to print this as Mr. so and so, whatever is received from the text box 1, right? Name should be equals to this plus T1 dot get text. Name should be equals to this plus text box is T1 dot get text. And now else what should be done? It has to be miss. So let me copy the same thing here, but here it should be string name equals to, this has to be this MS, that is miss whatever. It's showing the error, create local variable string. Okay. Otherwise, it has to be this. And after this, we need to provide something, right? That is good morning or whatever message that you want to print, whatever is the greeting that needs to be provided. So let me add that over here only. Good morning. This. Okay. So this is, so this will not just display it here. We are just storing this in the variable. We need to set this text on this particular label, that is L3, right? So to do that, we need to use L3 dot set text. So what should be the text here that is present in the variable N? So this is what is required here, right? So let's run this code. Fine, we have got this form. Give the name. Let me take the name as Neha. Give the contact numbers. And then I have chosen this and these hobbies. And submit this button. Submit. So you can see that I'm getting it as Good Morning, Miss Neha. Right? So let me change the names and the other details. Let me take it as Rahul and the contact number and choose mail over here and then submit. Now you can see that it is displaying Good Morning, Mr. Rahul. Right? So what we have done here is, based on the details given, that is either male or female and the name, we are greeting that person with a proper salutation, that is Good Morning, Mr. Rahul, Good Morning, Miss Neha, something like that. All right? And also, it should allow me to choose the hobbies, right? All these. So let me summarize what we have done so far. Our intention was to create one such form, and based on the details given by the user, we should display something. So for that, we took these details, name from the user, contact number. So for this, we took two labels, and here we wanted two text boxes and then two radio buttons and four check boxes for the hobbies and then a submit button, and we need one label. We wanted a label over here because we wanted some text to be displayed over here. So to do that, first we wanted our class to be subclass of the JFrame. For that, you can observe that here our class FormDemo1 extends JFrame. So after this, we just created the reference of all those components required. We wanted three labels, we wanted two text fields, and two radio buttons and four checkboxes for the hobbies and one button. So these are all the references. And in the constructor, we created the objects of all those classes using the new keyword. You can see that we have provided the labels. Only for L3, I have kept the parameter blank because in the beginning, we did not want anything to be displayed at this place, isn't it? So that's the reason it was empty. So later, using the setText method, we assigned that. And then we created the two text fields, radio buttons, and all the checkboxes. And one important thing to remember here is, when you are creating the radio buttons and text boxes, you have to provide what text should be displayed along with that. Otherwise, when we executed this in the first run, it was just showing the radio buttons without any labels. Even the check boxes were displayed without any labels. to avoid that, you have to give the proper labels there. And then this button group class is very useful whenever you want any one of the buttons to be chosen among a set of buttons. For example, here we have two radio buttons. We shouldn't allow the user to select both, right? So any one should be selected. That is the reason we grouped these two buttons, radio buttons, and we have added those R1 and R2 radio buttons to the group so that it doesn't allow the user to choose both. And then we added the labels and the text boxes. See, this is the flow. The way you add these components to the frame, that is how it gets displayed when you execute this code. So when you are adding these components to the frame, make sure that you are adding it in a proper order. So if you have added label 1, label 2 in this order, it will take label 1, that is name, label 2 is contact number, and then if you have added the text box, so the order matters a lot here. I wanted a label to be displayed and then the text box, and then a label and the text box. That's the reason we have taken the order as L1, T1, L2, T2, the way we wanted it. So after this, we have added the action to this button, because when the user clicks on this submit button, what should happen? What action to be taken? So that we can specify using b1.addActionListener. So addActionListener is a method which is present in the interface ActionListener. We need to implement that interface because we want to use that method. That is the reason when we created the class, we wrote this particular keyword, wherein we wrote this as implement action listener, right? So when we implement an interface, we have to override the method. We need to provide the implementation of the method, the definition for the method, which is declared in the interface. So there is a method called as action performed, which is an abstract method in the action listener interface. We have provided the definition for this. So always this action performed will have statements wherein upon clicking any button, what action should be taken, what action has to be performed. So here, based on which radio button is selected, we wanted to greet that person with this message and also the proper suitable salutation, right? So for that, we are first checking whether that is selected. So isSelected is a method that gives, that returns a Boolean value. If it is true, then you have to print this, and along with that t1.getText. See, this t1.getText refers to this particular text box, because from this text field we are fetching the name of the person and we are prefixing that with a proper salutation. So if the radio button 1, that is R1, is chosen, then we need to give this as Mr., right? If it is this, then we have to change this. That is taken care by this if statement. So if R1.isSelected, then we need to assign this particular text to the variable n. So n is a variable of type string. Otherwise, it has to do this second task. And finally, we need to set this text to the label. See, unless you set this text to this label, nothing gets displayed on the screen. It will be stored in the variable n. But when you execute this code, what we need here is this thing has to be displayed on the window, right? So for that, we have used l3.setText, which was empty in the beginning. When we created the object of L3 label, we had kept that parameter as blank. Nothing was passed because we wanted to print it later once we get all the details from the user. So now we are setting that text to this label, right? So once again, let's run this code and see how it works. So give the name over here and give the contact number, and if you wish any other details to be added, you can provide that. Choose the hobbies and then click on this submit. You can see that we are getting the output. And similarly, now if you change this and select the appropriate radio button and submit this, you can see the appropriate output based on which radio button is selected. So you can even modify this code wherein you can display which are the hobbies that he has selected. You can display those, right? So here, for example, singing and coding are the hobbies of this person. So you can print a message. So these are your hobbies, something like that. So you can even list that. Based on which checkbox is selected, you can give a proper message. So you can modify this code. I hope this is clear to you all. We have a lot of other components available in Swing. You can make use of all those components to develop these Swing applications as per your requirement. So first, try all these components and then see whether you are getting the expected output. And if you get any doubts, you can contact me. Okay, thank you. Take care.